C2 continues to celebrate Black History Month. Last night, we introduced you to some of the descendants of the first black family on Sanibel Island. Tonight, NBC2's Ashley Graham examines what could happen to the school that their family once attended.
There's a piece of black history right next to Doc Ford's, and like most of Sanibel,
we had 78 inches of water in our store, so it's very challenged at the moment.
The inside is gutted, but it's still standing, just like it has through dozens of storms for more than a century.
The history of the building was its real asset.
Give us a call. We'd be happy to help you.
Before Ian, this was the home of Lily & Company, a jewelry store, for 17 years.
It was light and bright and airy, and I wanted everybody to feel comfortable walking in.
Before that, it was a bank, an art gallery, and a podiatrist's office. And in the 1900s, it was the only school for the few black children on Sanibel.
And they weren't, children were not allowed to go to school in those days. The school was just for white children. And in 1924, the Baptist Church informally opened a school for black children.
Black sharecroppers made their way to Sanibel to work on farms in the 20th century. When the church decided to open a school,
there was a minimum of 7 children had to be there for the school to operate.
Those 7 students all came from one family, the Gavin family.
Dad did leave a message with them that I can do that because I have more than 7. They opened the school, and we went there for 4 years, and then we had to go to Fort Myers because it couldn't go over 7th grade.
Over the years, people on Sanibel have taken steps to honor that history, even as the owners of the building changed. The church-turned-school-turned-jewelry store is on Sanibel's historical register, and it will keep that recognition now that Lily & Company's owners are stepping away, driven out by the storm.
So when this happened, it was the next right thing to do to let the store go and let someone else put their love into it.
Co-owner Karen Bell listed the property earlier this year. It won't join the historical village just a few miles away.
We don't have room. Very sadly, we don't have room here in the village for it. I wish we did.
But Bell says its new buyers still want to honor its history and restore the parts that washed away.
Before Hurricane Ian hit, there used to be a plaque that sat right here, and it showcased all of the building's history, including its black history. It washed away during the storm, and the hope is for the new owners to bring some of that history back to the forefront.
Bell says with time, it will be renewed.
They are very interested in the history of the building and keeping it historic.
There are lots of aspects of the island's history that need to be protected and preserved, and its black history is definitely part of that. I hope that this building is able to be preserved and that that history is becomes ingrained into the culture again.
Reporting on Sanibel for NBC2, I'm Ashley Graham.